Thank you very much. Our group member have tried to discuss on the first issue, users, librarians, IT staffs, and university managers, researchers, on the, and they, I think, in their contribution on the open access policies. With regard to users, we have put like this. Users have to know their rights and duties. So that if they know their rights and duties, they can go in line with that policy, and they can maintain their rights and no problem in general if they know their duties and rights. They have to go in line with the policies. This is what we have raised with regard to the users. With regarding to librarians are expected to give awareness to the users, awareness of the policy, awareness of what's available in the library, whatever. Give training or give awareness to the users regarding the open access policies. Put the data or enter the data to the system. They may facilitate to have the available researches in the open access system. To manage or coordinate the open access policy, to facilitate the necessary materials, to help people in finding information and the contact research for personal and professional use. This is what we have raised with regarding to users, I mean librarians. The next one is IT staffs. The IT staff, they are expected to configure and customize the system, giving technical service, work to have backup of the repository. If something is missing with the system, having a backup is very important, so that we are thinking like that. Give training to the librarian, because the IT staff may is expected more have more knowledge or experiences with regarding to the system, so that they are expected to give trainings to the librarians. Update and upgrading the system also has to be the task of the IT staff. University managers, they may allow the necessary budget to the work. They may approve the open access policy and follow its implementation in their respective universities. We may have an open access policy, but that policy has to be approved or accepted by our by the respective university managers. And following that, the implementation of that open access policy is the key issue, I think. Regarding to the researchers, they have to work their research in line with the policies, and they may submit their data or their final research to the library. That is all what we have raised. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon. We discussed question number two, technical readiness to uptake NADRE service needs. Basically, we have discussed in the group. The first, we need training about ICT staff and library staffs. It needs training about to ready to take this service, and also we create awareness about top management to implement these NADRE services we discuss as a group. And also it needs digital libraries staff, digital library staff. And also it needs infrastructures like well-organized servers, ICT, and so on. And also we create awareness about researchers to give their papers, and also we give training for them about patent, copyright. They may fear to submit their papers or their publication, so that we give training for the researcher. And also we discuss about make a good structures. That means organizational structures need about to follow up these NADRE projects, this NADRE project. So we discuss about this point. Thank you.
Our group discussed on the issue about readiness or availability of experts and needs to implement this NADRE project. So we are seen in different ways. For example, on the first, about readiness. According, we can take an example of our university as one of the institution. Yes, really, they have ready to deploy this open access service availability, but it depends on the situation. What the first thing is the availability of experts. The availability of experts means that the IT staffs or ICT staffs or experts to manipulate the service or open access service in the university. The librarians in different sections in the library system, and the researchers who submit their papers, and the publishers also. The publishers to publish the researchers' product, their outcomes. And also, Etsy, there is another stakeholders also on beside of this. And also the motivation for utilizing the open access service in the university. So this availability depends on or what they need. They need the first thing, training for experience sharing in between the stakeholders. Why? Because if there is no enough or mature experts in a given institution, they need a training or experience sharing. And also infrastructures. The infrastructure, it may be the hardware, it may be the software. As we have seen today in the presentation, there is different software utilities. So to customize such softwares, we need hardware devices or hardware materials like servers. So such infrastructures also needed as an institution. And also the guidelines and policy to use the service or open access service, we need the guidelines or services. The guidelines may be the rules and regulation and the documentation service. How to use, how to manipulate, and how to govern all the services. And the other thing, the stakeholders. To be a strong institution or to deploy open access service in a given institution, we need stakeholders. Like, for example, GIs, like SK, such like stakeholders are useful for or to being a strong institution or university to manipulate these NADRE services. This is all about our group discussion. Thank you.
I'm the representative of Group 4, and we have discussed on the issue of role of universities, internet, and Ministry of Education for the implementation of NADRE. Therefore, based on our group discussion, I will just explain some points that we have put as a role, which is expected from the three stakeholders for implementing the NADRE. From the universities, the following core responsibilities are expected, which should be fulfilled by each university for implementing and for realizing the NADRE project. The first one is that content creation, which means that each university is expected to develop or manage their research outputs for making accessible nationwide. The other point, the other responsibility is that developing its own repository. If there is no repository previously, this is also another responsibility. Having an IT expert, developing a repository can't be achieved without having an IT expert. Therefore, the universities have an experts which are enough for developing digital repositories according to the direction which is given from NADRE. The university should fulfill the IT infrastructure. This is obviously the expectation from each university. In addition to that, the university should give an awareness on how to use the national repository for the researchers, for the students and other users. This is also another expectation from each universities. Now let's come to the other stakeholder, the Ethernet or Ethiopian Research and Education Network. This is an organization and it has its own role for implementing the NADRE project. Therefore, our group members have discussed or put some core ideas which are expected from the Ethernet organization or company. The first one is that providing the server or the infrastructure, the cloud, for having a common repositories. When we say this one, we are going to access a common digital repository nationwide. Therefore, the Ethernet is expected to give the cloud or the storage, the database server for each of the universities. The other point is that technical support. This is also another expectation from each of the universities. Give training for universities or IT staffs. This is also another issue or task that we are expecting from the Ethernet. The Ethernet should give the instructions how go for linking our local repositories with the NADRE. This is a direction which is going to be given by the Ethernet. The last one, the last stakeholder for which gives a great responsibility for the NADRE project, for implementing the NADRE project, is Ministry of Education. We have already listed around three points which are expecting from the Ministry of Education for realizing the NADRE project. The first one is giving financial support for the universities for developing their repository, for managing their data content, even for building their infrastructure, IT infrastructure, for each of the universities. The second one, coordinating each of the universities to work together. Because the project is going to give us a common repository national-wise, therefore, we need to have a coordination among each of the universities so that this should be coordinated by the representative of Ministry of Education. Developing and giving licensing issues for that repository. This is the policies, the standards should be developed and given by the Ministry of Education. This is what we have discussed. Thank you.